Joe Galati, we are going to talk about things that are in your freezer, namely frozen fruit and frozen vegetables. So, come with me.
Typically, we would say nothing canned, nothing frozen. We want fresh fruits, fresh vegetables. But on occasion, it's perfectly okay to get frozen vegetables as long as they are pure and unprocessed. You really have to look at the labels before you buy any frozen vegetables. The same thing goes for frozen fruits. They really are, in some respects, possibly even more nutritious than the fruit that you buy at the grocery store, because these are frozen immediately when they're pulled from their plant and lock in the nutrients, rather than having fruit that may be actually a few weeks old by the time it reaches the supermarket where you go to buy it. So I have a few examples of some frozen vegetables and some frozen fruits that we have at the Galati house that we use from time to time when those fresh fruits and vegetables are not available. And really, it is a convenience factor to have these available in a pinch when you want to cook some vegetables. So the Bird's Eye Company makes a whole series of different frozen vegetables called steamers, steam fresh. And these are to be cooked right in this plastic bag in a microwave. And if you look at the ingredients, they have essentially nothing but the vegetable in it. There's no added sodium, there's no added sugar. And, you know, this is the family size that we have here. And so it's enough for a family of four or five to get a decent serving of vegetables. And again, the key thing is that these are unprocessed. Keep in mind, unprocessed, you don't want anything that has added salt, cheese, flavoring, nothing. These is just the plain vegetables that you would eat. Here's another variety from Kroger's, another local grocery store here in Texas. And this is a three pepper and onion blend. So this throws in a little bit more of a colorful combination that you could use as stir fry, to use with some chicken or some beef or some fish. And again, this is unprocessed. There's no added salt or sodium in them. When you're looking at these vegetables, they're very low in sodium. They have only 10 milligrams of sodium per serving. And so that's basically what you're getting in nature. There's no fat, only 25 calories per serving, which is absolutely terrific, and only 3 grams of sugar. And these are going to be the natural sugars that occur in food naturally, which we're always going to have. It's when you have all the added salt and sugar and garbage in these vegetables that you get into trouble. But so these are just some examples, but you have to be good consumers to look at the labels to see really what you are buying with regard to frozen vegetables.
Now, with regard to frozen fruit, we like to have frozen blueberries, and here is a frozen fruit blend for smoothies. It's strawberries, mangoes, and pineapple. These are good just thawed out, or you could throw them into the blender. And again, these have pretty good shelf life, and as I said, they are very nutritious despite the fact that they are frozen. They still have the same phytonutrients, they still have the fiber and antioxidant properties that you would have with the fresh berries.
And so hopefully you'll get an idea that while, again, we say time and time again, fresh fruit, fresh vegetables, and fresh meat, it is okay to get the frozen vegetables and frozen fruits as long as they are pure and they are unprocessed with no added sugar, salt, fat, or other seasonings. That's where you're really going to derail and not get the best nutrition possible. So hopefully this was helpful to everybody watching, and we'll see you again soon.